Well, now we're going to turn our attention toward the skies, specifically to some strange lights that some of your neighbors out near the Eagle Ford Shale oil field say they've seen. Reporter David Sears with our ABC affiliate in San Antonio takes a closer look.
You've got three distinct lights.
Pictures from oil rig security cameras.
It's hovering above us.
Videos from oil rig workers. And eyewitness accounts from ranchers.
Somewhere out there, there's something.
Are we alone? It seems like UFO sightings are occurring more frequently over the Eagle Ford Shale. Some can be explained.
It looked to the world like some sort of a craft sitting there.
But after Mutual UFO Network investigators got a closer look,
they have determined that it's not a craft at all.
Turned out it was some sort of vehicle. But then some sightings are unexplained.
About 10% of them, those are the ones that'll make your eyes roll round and round in your head, and we can't figure it out.
They started blinking, one, two, three, one, two, three. It was like bing, 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 bing.
Penny Farrell and her husband Jerry saw those lights just above the horizon from the back porch of their South Texas ranch last November. No pictures, just memories.
All at once, they went back over here to this tree, but they were a little higher.
After several minutes of back and forth and blinking, they took off.
And when it shot up into the heavens, it was just like a blink of an eye, and boom, it was up there.
We scanned the big South Texas star-filled sky. We didn't see any flashing or darting lights, but just because we didn't see it tonight doesn't necessarily mean it's not out there.
If you were here and saw it like we saw it, sat here and marveled over what was happening up there in the sky, then you'd say, that's a UFO.
Along the Eagle Ford Shale in South Texas, David Sears, KSAT 12 News.
Good evening. Thank you for being here tonight. We begin in the skies above Vancouver Island. In the past week, there have been multiple reports of strange flying objects darting across the horizon above Victoria. On Friday, a meteor streaked across BC, working its way down into Washington State. But it's what else was in the sky that night that has many curious, including a prominent UFO researcher who says he's now on the case. CTV's Gord Kurbis has the story.
A meteor tracking website shows the January 11th reports of people sighting a fiery object in the sky traveling from BC towards Washington State. But it seems that a meteor may not have been the only thing in the sky at that time.
There are definitely some odd stuff took place on the 11th, and it took place on the island and the Victoria area around there, and definitely in the lower mainland.
Brian Vike is a UFO investigator based in Houston, British Columbia. That's right, the other Houston. His blog, The Vike Factor, is now filled with sightings from the 11th of strange lights and a triangular-shaped object the size of a school bus over Vancouver Island.
A woman had taken her children to school. She stopped. This is after a 6:30 meteor sighting. She had looked up, a flash of the sky again, bang, here comes this solid object, triangular in shape, three orange balls in each of the points. She watched it move along, it came to a hover, and then bang, all the three balls of light went into the center, and bang, this thing was gone.
I looked up in the sky and I saw just this light coming over.
It doesn't look like it's from Earth. It looks like it's from somewhere else.
Hovering in the skies across several parts of the country. This video is from Indianapolis of a strange formation that appeared this week. Now, people in Metro Detroit say they've seen something just like it. Last night, our newsroom and our Facebook page got several reports of strange lights in the skies over Metro Detroit. And tonight, Fox News' Ron Savage is on a mission to find out what they really are. Ron.
Huel, you know how we operate here. We do stories on talkers, and this is a talker. Everybody's talking about it. What are the lights in the sky? Mysterious lights in the sky. Many Metro Detroiters have been wondering, what am I seeing?
It wasn't quite as high as you would see. I've been watching the airplanes tonight, and it wasn't quite as high as them. And I mean, like I said, you could actually see the triangle shape of the object.
David Levy was outside Thursday night, 9:30 p.m. with friends in Flat Rock, and suddenly
we were outside and up in the sky. We saw a triangle-shaped light with. Or a triangle-shaped object with about five lights flashing, heading north.
Who saw it first, a friend or?
I did, yes.
Yeah, what'd you say?
I asked people, what do you think that is? And everybody was like, I don't know. And then later on at night, I found out that people had been seeing this object all over.
In fact, our Fox 2 Facebook page has been blowing up with hundreds of posts, people seeing lights like Lisa. She writes, I seen some in Southgate, but thought it was fireworks and weird for January. Nick writes, I assumed they were planes. They were flying in the same direction. I watched them for about 10 minutes, and I counted four or five of them. I'm over in St. Clair Shores. Mario writes, I seen it in East Point off 9 Mile. It was something crazy. And Sean writes, I was the one who called into the Fox 2 newsroom and first broke this story. They were black triangle-shaped objects making circles over West Bloomfield and Farmington Hills. There was no noise, and they had bright lights. I'm not making this up, and I know somebody else saw these things. These lights are all over YouTube. The original poster says they were shot in Miami this week. And these lights were said to be shot in Indianapolis. Is this similar to what David saw in Flat Rock?
This kind of looks like a stand in one spot, but that's exactly what it looked like.
Really, that's unusual around the new year.
However, some Cleveland residents say they saw something more than your typical firework display. Eyewitness News reporter Katie McCall joins us live with the story, all new at 6. Katie?
Gina, a Cleveland woman who says she has never before spotted a UFO, swears that she saw one hovering in the trees right over US 59. Now, a UFO investigator is looking into whether this was a plane, a helicopter, or something from out of this world.
Just there, like, you know, this.
On December 30th, Lauren Harris was on Highway 59 in Cleveland when a brightly lit cylinder hovering in the sky caused her to pull over.
Strange, like the lights were pulsating on it and it would disappear for a few seconds and it would reappear in the same spot. And then we noticed too that it wasn't moving at all. So we're like, no, it can't be an airplane, and what would a helicopter be doing this late at night over the woods? I think it was a UFO.
The nursing student says she tried to document the encounter.
I put my phone up like this, and I tried taking a picture of it, and then I put it back down, and it was gone.
But never expected to be taken seriously. To her surprise, Fletcher Gray from MUFON, the Mutual UFO Network, is investigating.
I have verified over 345 cases.
Gray looks into reports of extraterrestrial vehicles, alien encounters, and aircraft modeled after alien vehicles not acknowledged by the government.
This was verified by two independent witnesses. This is a UFO because we don't know if it belongs extraterrestrial.